Okay, it's estimated as many as 70% of women suffer from imposter syndrome. Joining us on And Mum Pedia Pro 3 Coffee Group to talk about overcoming feelings of inadequacy, author and life coach Jess Stewart and socialpreneur Vanessa Baxter. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
That's a great title too, by the way. Jess, let's start with you. What exactly is imposter syndrome?
So imposter syndrome, Mel, is this concept that describes high-achieving individuals that have an inability to internalise their success. So it might sound like one of these days, they're going to find out that I don't know as much as they seem to think that I do. And it can come from our fear of being exposed as a fraud. We feel like we might get found out. We also can be reluctant to accept praise and sort of put success down to things that are outside of ourselves a lot of the time.
Wow, that's interesting. And I don't think there's a single woman I know who can accept praise in a general way, that's for sure. Vanessa, why do you think so many women in particular undervalue their achievements?
I think it's, there's obviously many reasons that women do, but I think in general it's really hard for women to take credit where credit's due. You know, we tend to sort of have this feeling that we need to be humble and grateful for our successes rather than sort of shouting it from the rooftop and saying, hey, I've worked really hard to achieve this. We tend not to do that, you know, and we're juggling and multitasking. So often we'll look at the thing that we haven't quite succeeded in that day and go, oh no, you know, I haven't made it today. You know, I haven't done that I'd sort of set myself a task for, rather than, wow, you know, I've achieved all these other things, you know, and we'll take breaks and things, go back to work and then question where we are in the workplace because we've done something different to our peers. So it's sort of a little bit judgmental on ourselves about where we are.
It's also like the thing, like with the Facebook comments, if you read a whole lot of Facebook comments and they're all very flattering and there's that one negative one, that's the one that everyone remembers, isn't
it? Yeah, that's the one you feel that everyone remembers.
Well, it's the one you remember, that's for sure. We remember. Jess, is imposter syndrome, is it becoming more common, do you think?
It certainly feels that way. I think it's something that becomes more common the more success we achieve. But also with the popularity of terms like authenticity and vulnerability, I think we're hearing a lot more about it. So we didn't used to like to admit to having a weakness. It was a secret that we kept to ourselves. But I think now it's more acceptable for us to admit to having these feelings of imposter syndrome, even if we're really high up in our careers.
It's almost a trend too on social media, isn't it, to talk about those feelings.
This is true. It's becoming fashionable now to have some vulnerability.
I was going to say that. It's a bit on trend, isn't it? Vanessa, is it a case of putting too much value on other people's sort of opinions or perceptions on what we're doing?
Well, I think in general with women in particular, we do tend to value other people's perceptions of us. So we will compare ourselves to others and say, oh my gosh, look at what she's achieved. I've done nothing in my life. You know, I'm here and I haven't done half of what she's done, so we'll tend to do that. But then there's the flip side as well, where we might be multitasking and juggling so many different facets of our lives, and then there may be a partner or a family member who says, gosh, you know, it would have been great if you'd been a better financial contributor to our family along the way, and you forget all those amazing things that you have done, and it starts to chip away at a woman's self-confidence or self-esteem, and they dwell on that one negative. You know, we're back to that problem where you sort of define your whole self on the one negative rather than, you know, looking at all the achievements that you've done in other areas.
But I'm sure too that also women who have that, who are real high achievers in their jobs and things, still have those feelings as well.
Oh, totally.
So Jess, how do mums returning to the workforce push through this feeling? Because I'm sure it's something that they, well, it is something I know from experience of not really belonging in either world.
Totally. And the world moves at such a fast pace now. A lot changes, particularly over the course of a year. It can feel like we've been left behind. And it certainly feeds those feelings of insecurities and those doubts. I think for me, one of the top tips is about identifying some quick wins. So being able to rebuild that self-efficacy by having those quick wins and those things that come, we can start proving to ourselves what we already know that we're capable of. We just need that reminder.
Yeah.
I think it's also important for us to understand where our role fits in the business that we're returning to, our career plan over 5 years, but also very importantly, our life ambitions and the values that we hold dear, because I think the balance of both is so important.
Yes, and our expectations. We've just got time for a very quick tip from you, Vanessa. What's a top tip from you?
I think surround yourself with other successful women who are prepared to celebrate success and celebrate it with them. You know, celebrate your achievements. You don't have to shout it from the rooftops if you feel uncomfortable doing that, but be proud of where you've got, acknowledge how you've got there, because it gives strength to other women to be able to do the same.
Absolutely. Fantastic advice. Great. Thank you both so much.
Welcome.
Excellent advice. The Coffee Group is brought to you by And Mum Pedia Pro 3, the only toddler milk with no added sugars. Now, if you have any worries that you'd like addressed by our parenting panel, message us on the Cafe Facebook Facebook page. One contributor is going to win this cool ebook from Ann Mum.
Good night, Mel. Here's a story just for you.
That's a new recording. Thanks, Mike. I like that one. I'll take that one home. It allows you to record your voice reading the story. That sounded a bit creepy, didn't it? Congratulations to this week's winner, Caroline Love. Your prize is on its way, and you can record your voice.